Hey, I'm Kevin, and today I'm going to show you how I made this coat rack in the Kevbotworkshop. Welcome back to the Kevbotworkshop. Today we're going to make this coat rack with custom ebonized hooks using a little bit of science.
Science!
That never gets old.
Nope.
I have actually never used white oak before, but I thought I would get my hands on it before I use it on a larger project coming up. This is also a great opportunity for me to use some of the wood that was lying around the shop. Though I have never used white oak before, I had some on hand because it came with a great deal of lumber I got on Craigslist.
That's a good deal.
As always, I started out with breaking down my material and surfacing them. These two boards are going to be joined and glued together to make a larger panel for the back of the rack. I've always wanted to try the Jackman way of taking off clamps because it just seems so convenient. But I learned you just have to have the right touch.
Before I send this back through the planer, I'm going to use my palm router to remove the rest of the glue. Then I'll be able to bring this down to its final thickness of 3/4. What I also have here are some boards that I think were from an oak bed that I'm going to plane and get the finish off. And I'm going to use this for the actual backing of it so I can use it for the French cleat system.
After planing these boards, it became pretty apparent that these were not in fact oak, but actually ash. These boards are really not going to be seen, so I think the ash and the oak will blend nicely.
Wow, I can't believe it!
After the panel had been cleaned up, I can clean up the edges. For the ends, I wanted a continuous grain rather than join two end grain boards like this after they had been glued up. To do this, I'm going to make some strategic miter cuts. If you haven't seen my board game box video, I explain how it's done there. To secure this to the wall, I'm going to use a French cleat. With a French cleat, you can cut an angle through the board. I did 45 degrees here. Then attach one side of the French cleat to your piece while the other side is attached to the wall. Many woodworkers use them so they can move pieces around their shop because they are not fixed down. I'm specifically using it as a means of support for a large piece, but also to hide the support. I also placed a piece on the bottom so that the bottom could be supported. After these are attached, I can trim the edges so they are flush. I used painter's tape and a crosscut sled to hold them in place because I felt this was safer than using the fence on my table saw. For the glue up, I used painter's tape again and a little bit of CA glue so that the miters can be held tight as the wood glue dries. For the most part, these turned out pretty good. Any gaps can be fixed by filling or rounding over with a screwdriver. I can now start working on the shelf. To attach this, I'm going to use a dado joint. To keep the shelf clean, I am making a tongue to insert into the dado. After cutting the horizontal side of the shoulder, I can cut the vertical side to make the tongue. With most of the tongue cut, I can use a chisel to clean up the rest.
So I'm getting ready here to actually cut the dado into my coat rack. But before I did that, I actually ran some tests and some pine here. What I did here was I set the dado set to 1/2 inch, which is what the tongue is on the actual shelf piece. And I made a cut here just as a test. I also came here and I made a stop because I'm gonna be doing a stop dado in the actual coat rack. And so I drew a line after here so I can see where the blade will actually stop where I want it to stop. So once I did that line there, I transferred it to the top and I sent it through here. And when it comes to the stop, touching the blade, it'll actually be touching my line here. So now I know exactly where I can actually stop the blade when it's on the coat rack by putting a line here. So what I have here are two lines. The smaller line here is the actual length of the shelf, which is 20 inches. This line here is at 19.5 inches. I'm leaving a little bit of extra space here just in case there's any gaps or anything I can cover up with that. This 19.5 inch line is very important to me because that is where it's actually going to stop with my table saw blade. So with the line that I set on my table saw fence, I'll be able to stop exactly where I want it to be, which is this line here. I can always clean up this stuff afterwards, this curve that's in here, but for now, I just need to make sure that I stop right here and not all the way up to this line. You can see here it was actually pretty close. It slightly went over the line, but that's okay. I left room for error, so that was actually perfect.
Now that I have most of the backboard finished, I'm going to transition into making the hooks.
Now this is not a scale, but this is a drawing of what I'm actually looking for here with the hook. So I kind of saw a couple of different things online to make this almost L shape here as the hook. And the way I'm working it out is that I'm trying to find the angles to actually cut this in a safe way so that I can actually make these and not hurt myself. To do this, I'm going to be cutting out a blank of these hooks and then I'll be able to cut them apart afterwards. So what I'm actually going to be looking for is a piece that is 2 inch by 4 inch, and then we can actually cut in the angles and then we'll cut it apart.
I have this offcut of 8/4 oak from a project that I have coming up in the future. Since this is too big for my joiner, I'm going to use this little trick of gluing popsicle sticks to the bottom before sending it through the planer. This will give me my one flat side, and then I can remove the pieces and flatten the other side. After that, I can cut out the 2 inch by 4 inch blank. From there, I drew on the side of the blank the shape of the hook. While cutting these, I did not dial in an exact angle on the table saw, but instead lined up the piece to the blade and tilted it until it looked just right. Cutting all these angles can be a little tricky and scary, so please take the proper precautions to ensure your safety. I even placed the fence on the other side of the blade for one of these cuts, just because it made more sense. I got a fair bit of burning on the second cut, so I decided to clean it up with a sander before cutting the last angle. Once I got the angles cut, I can cut them apart at 1 inch each. With a little bit of sanding, these are just about done. I also made smaller hooks to hang your keys. Now it's time to do a little bit of science.
Science rules.
Actually, I'm pretty terrible at science, but what I'm doing here is pretty simple. I'm making a mixture of quadruple zero steel and white vinegar to ebonize the wood. After a few days, the vinegar will break down the steel wool and the iron ions will react with the tendons in the white oak to gray the wood. If you use some strong black tea before the steel wool mixture, it will make the wood black. Before I ebonized the hooks, I drilled for screws and countersank. In between each coat, I sanded to 320 grit. After the final coat, they kind of looked rusty brown, but once I put a coat of finish on them, it made them true black. To go along with the black hooks, I needed some black screws. I had some zinc-coated screws that I made black using a bluing process. First, I had to remove the zinc from the screws, and I did that with citric acid and water. Once the zinc is removed, I dip them in some super glue to turn them black. Now it's time for the finishing touches. I sanded the backboard up to 320 grit and then 400 grit by hand. I typically don't sand that high, but for this project I'm using Odie's oil for the first time as I wanted to use it on a future project. After using Odie's on this, I can really get used to using this as a finish. It's very easy to apply and I like the natural feel to the finish. With the finish on all the pieces, I can do the final assembly. Because of the French cleat, installation was a piece of cake. After finding the studs and screwing the other side of the cleat to the wall, this project is done. This turned out great. I was able to try a few new things and make something beautiful and modern. If you like this project, hit that like and subscribe button and turn on that bell to get a notification when new videos come out.
One more take. Please stop saying don't forget to like and subscribe.
Sure, but how are we gonna get followers on this thing, man?
If you wanna see more videos right now, I have a couple loaded up for you right here. That's it for now. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time in the Kevbot Workshop.